Hi, good morning, my dear friends. Once again, welcome back to our social science class. You know, in previous class, we were focusing on our geography part. And you know, the first chapter was about Europe, peninsula of Asia. In this chapter, we are going to learn more about the Europe. Okay, and you know, we can see there are 7 continents are there in the world, and out of these 7 continents of the world, Europe is 6th largest continent. Okay, and you know that the 7 continents of the world are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Australia and Antarctica. These are the 7 continents of the world. Out of these 7 continents of the world, Europe is the 6th position on the size. Okay, and it is very small continent. You know, it is 6th position on the size, and it has, even though it is small, population is also highly popular. Population is highly highly dense. Okay, we can see huge population in Europe, and the climate is in northern part of Europe. The climate is entirely cold, severe cold, and in the south it is somewhat temperate climate. Okay, neither too cold or neither too hot. Okay, and these are the basic of Europe, and you know, many countries are there in Europe. On the map, in textbook, you can see the European map and the countries. Many countries, you know, Britain, Germany, Italy, France, Norway, Sweden, Denmark, Finland, Greenland, Ireland, Poland, Switzerland. Many countries you can see in the European continent. Okay, and another thing, you know, the location of Europe. Where is Europe located? Okay, on the globe, you can see in between 10 degree west and 60 degree east longitude, we can locate the position of Europe. I repeat once again, 10 degree west to 60 degree east longitude, we can locate the location of Europe on the globe. And listen, my dear students, in between 36 degree north and 72 degree north latitude, we can locate the position of Europe. Okay, and sometimes some students may not know what is latitude and longitude. For their benefit, I am repeating what is latitude and longitude. Okay, you know, latitudes are the horizontal lines passing through the globe from west to east. That is known as latitude. And this latitudes are used in order to measure the temperature of the earth. Okay, in the equatorial region, in the middle part of the earth, the temperature is very high, whereas in the both polar regions, north and south frigid zones, the temperature is very cold. Okay, and in between equator and polar region, we can see the moderate temperature. We call it as temperate region. Okay, and coming to longitude, you know, longitudes are the vertical lines passing from north to south on the globe. Vertical lines are the lines passing from north to south. Okay, and that is about latitude and longitude. And you see, now let us see the area of Europe. The size, the area of Europe is 104 million square kilometer. Okay, area is 104 million square kilometer is the area of Europe. Okay, and when we take the whole population of the world, the quarter part, that is 1/4 of the population, we can see in the Europe. Okay, so I hope you understood the basic things about Europe. And you know, what is the barrier between Europe and Asia? Okay, there is a huge mountain called Ural Mountain. Ural Mountain divides Europe and Asia. Okay, that is the boundary of Europe and Asia, Ural Mountains. Okay, and you know Russia. Russia is a big country. Majority around 75% of Russia is located in the Asian continent, whereas the western part of Russia is located in Europe. Okay, the Russian territory which is located in Europe is known as Eurasia. Europe plus Russia, that is Eurasia. Okay, Eurasia. And another thing, both Asia and Europe is known as Eurasia. Europe plus Asia is equal to Eurasia. Okay, don't confuse. One is Eurasia and second one is Eurasia. Okay, Eurasia means Europe plus Asia is known as combined form of Europe and Asia is known as what? Eurasia. Whereas the territory of Russia in Europe is known as Eurasia. Okay, Russia in Europe, that is the meaning of Eurasia. Okay, I hope you understood. Now next, my dear students, you know, our Himalaya is the highest peak in the world. Okay, the approximate height is around 9 kilometers. Okay, 8998 is the height of Himalaya. Okay, and approximately we can say 9 kilometer. Okay, and here the height of the highest peak in Europe is known as Mount Blanc on the Alps mountain ranges. Okay, on Alps mountain ranges we can see this Mount Blanc. Its height is 4807 is the height of Mount Blanc, the highest mountain peak in the highest point of the mountain is known as peak. Okay, the topmost point of a mountain is known as a peak, and it is 4807, just half of our Himalaya. Okay, and let us see the boundaries of Europe. On north we can see a sea called Barents Sea. North of Europe it is Barents Sea, and in west we can see it is Atlantic Ocean, and in south it is Mediterranean Sea, and in east we can see it is our Asian continent. Okay, and majority of the population of the world is concentrated in Asia, Africa and Europe. Okay, and in North America and South America the population is very less compared to these three continents, mainly Asia, Africa and Europe. Okay, and that is about the geography of Europe. And you know, they are also very rich country in the world. Europe is sixth largest country in the world in size, and they are very rich. Okay, they are very hard working people, and they are industrialized country. You know, the agricultural field, everywhere we can see the touch of industry and technology. Okay, and you know that all the inventions, majority of the inventions are done by whom? Majority inventions are done by the Europeans. Okay, you know, the steam engine, telephone, telegraph, camera, television, radio. Okay, many inventions, including refrigerator, whatever we are using nowadays. Okay, everything was invented by and or discovered by the Europeans. Okay, so that is why we call them as industrialized country. And because of the arrival of British people to India, you know, they made the first railway line in between Bombay and Thane in the year of 1853. You might have studied these things in the previous classes. 1853, British government established the laid the foundation for the railway lines in India in between Bombay and Thane in the year of 1853. Sometimes if they might not came to India, sometimes we may be also living still now without any railway lines in India. Okay, so that is another, even though they made many negative impact to India, these are the some positive sides. They introduced the postal system, okay, fax, postal system, telegram, okay, and whatever the innovative things we are using, whatever the innovative technologies we are using is brought from Europe, okay. And they were very hard working, and moreover they were very smart working people, okay. We can see many scientists in from Europe, okay. And later these ideas went to America, okay. British government made many colonies in America, okay. And these things we will be studying in coming classes, okay. And coming to the another aspects of geography of Europe, we can see many mountains in Europe, and the temperature is the climate of Europe is temperate, neither very cold or very hot, okay. Especially in the southern part of Europe it is temperate. When we go to north part of Europe, the temperature is very cold, especially Norway, Finland, Sweden. These three countries are known as what? Scandinavian nations. Okay, it is known as Scandinavian nations, and they are number one in education in the world. Finland is number one in education, because what is the reason, you know? They are not spending any penny, any money for defense or to fight against their enemy. Okay, they are depositing this money for the welfare of the citizens, for giving proper education, proper health. In education and medical aspects, they are spending their income. Okay, and they are not wasting their money for fighting against the enemies, what we are doing. You know, our majority of our wealth we are spending for defense, in order to fight against our enemies, neighboring enemies, maybe Pakistan, China, Nepal, like that countries. Okay, for them there is no, they are not mainly, they are keeping friendship with their neighboring people, so there is no need of any worries, so there is no war. That money they are spending for education and medical. So they are the number one, the happiest people in the world. As per a research conducted recently, Finland is the happiest country in the world, because they are getting the number one education and the number one health also. And you know, their classes will start in the early morning. Early morning they will start their class, and around 12 noon they will stop the classes. Schools will close after 12 o'clock. After 12 o'clock it is a time for the students to play in their home. Okay, so students are very happy there. Okay, and coming to other aspects of Europe, you know, majority people are engaged in agriculture. Okay, you know, agriculture is the backbone of any country. For living we want food, okay. We can't eat any rock or stone. For food we want food, so they are also producing wheat, rice, maize, sugarcane, and moreover they are rearing cattle in order to get milk, okay. And this milk is used for human consumption, as well as for making confectionaries or sweets like chocolates. We are also using this milk, okay. Milk powder is also producing from milk, and they are all, Europeans are the number one producers of milk in the world. Okay, I hope you understood this segment, this part of geography about Europe. And coming sessions, coming remaining part we can taking in the coming classes, okay. That is about the mineral wealth, agriculture, okay. and many more things are yet to be learned. So till then, take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.